it's Jasmine, and as you saw, we just did some lipstick swatches of the brand new Kaleidos Liquid Lipstick Apple Collection. I'm really excited to talk more about these because I feel like I have a more of a review now that I've tried their original liquid lipsticks to these ones, and I want to go ahead and just deep dive more into them. So the dark purple set that I have here is Trophy, and then the light purple set here is Mercy. Both sets contain 4 liquid lipsticks, and they're $35 each. If you're curious on what is on my lips right now, it is the very last shade that I swatched, which is the shade Bare from the Mercy collection. Now, typically with all of my try-on reviews, I usually just wear the last style that I wore in the try-on because I think it's just easier. So let's go ahead and talk about my favorite set between the two in this Apple collection. And I'm gonna have to say it goes to Trophy. No pun intended. So I really like this set in particular because I really love the dark vampy shades. You know, there's a red, there's a dark plum, there's a burgundy, and there's even a black. And I really like that because I feel like with a lot of liquid lipsticks, they tend to really crack. Now, these are very interesting because it's more of a velvet mousse formula. So it hydrates the lips, it locks in that moisture without feeling super drying, but you don't feel it on the lips as well. And it's really great, especially when you're working with a lot of color. However, because these colors are really dark, sometimes it can be a little bit patchy on the first swipe, but then if you go in with the second swipe, it's totally fine. It won't mess up that formula, it won't feel cakey on the lips, and it'll just look more pigmented and put together. Now, I think that just comes with the formula though, because when you use a lot of velvet liquid lipsticks, you tend to get that nice sheer layer first for the gradient lip effect, and then you go in with the second coat right in the center so that you get more of that pigment right in the middle there. So I think that is what is to be expected with the dark colors, but I think that the darker tones really suit me and maybe my vibe right now because it is fall. And a lot of you guys might be actually very surprised because I love my nudes, but the Mercy set, I feel like these are the type of nudes that I don't wear. I found that the purpley nude here, the Mercury Wave, was really similar to Coven by Kat Von D, KVD now, and I felt like it's been a while since I've tried Coven, but when I first swatched it, it felt so similar in color, and then the rest of them, I just felt like they were really, really pink. Even this color that I have on my lips, the Bare shade, I feel like this is the most pink I would go for my lips. Like anything more than this, I would feel really uncomfortable. This is still outside of my comfort zone because I'm more of like a yellow nude person for the lips. I know that sounds really weird, but this is just definitely one of those things that I have to get used to, but the colors are really pretty. I briefly spoke about the formula being that it is a velvet texture. Now these actually last on the lips for a really, really long time. Once you let it set on the lips, there is like little to no transfer at all, and I really like that. So what I've done recently is I've actually been using these as eye primers because my eyes have been watering a lot. When it's usually a change of season, I usually find that my allergies flare up a little bit, so using these as like an eyelid base prior to eyeshadow actually helps me out a lot, and it also doesn't really stain. I can't say staining for the red shades or the dark shades because I haven't used it on my eyes, but as far as like the nude shades are concerned, it works really well for my eyeshadow, and I really like it because, again, that velvet texture really helps it blend out, and that first layer is usually sheer, so when you blend it out, it doesn't blend out into a harsh line, it blends out evenly and into the skin, which is beautiful. So it is definitely like a 2-in-1 product for me. So even though I'm probably not going to be utilizing all of these nude shades on the lips, I'm probably just going to use them for the eyes. It's not really a big deal. Aside from the lipstick formula, I think everything is beautiful, from the packaging to the tin that it comes in, which you could definitely reuse. But I think the only con that I have, it's just like something super minor. It's just the fact that like you can't really see the color distinction between the lipstick shades because it is more of like a frosted matte finish here, so you can't really see unless you take the product out or unless you know what shade you want to use. It's not a huge problem, but it is something that I've noticed, and it is something that I feel like is a little time consuming, especially when I'm trying to rush in the morning and I'm like, oh, what shade should I use, like, you know, for my eyes or for my lips? So it definitely does take time when you want to be in a rush that day, but aside from that, everything else is honestly fine. I think $35 is a very fair price point for these because it's less than $10 per lipstick. And I think that when you get a formula that you personally really enjoy, I think that that is honestly not, that's not breaking the bank, honestly, because I've used the Sandcastle Quad like almost every single day for my eye base. And honestly, these two, I think they're gonna be implemented a little bit more in my routine once the fall and winter seasons start to roll in a little bit more. Once the leaves start actually changing, I think that's when the lipsticks will start to change too for me. So I hope you guys all really enjoy this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I don't have a discount code, I'm sorry. I know some people ask me if I do, I don't. I just wanted to genuinely bring you guys this review and tell you guys my honest thoughts and opinions. So as always, I hope you guys all have a really good day, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Peace out, Girl Scouts.